Hello, everybody. So, the whole team is having breakfast without the team leader. Mother, Emil is very busy and won't come home for breakfast.
Well, comrade team leader, help yourself to the pancakes and tell us what work we are to do.
Our most important task for the next 4 or 5 days is to pick the apricots. They are already ripe. The orchard is golden with fruit.
I want to pick cherries.
But you can't, Nelly. There are no cherries at the end of July. Now we'll pick apricots, then peaches, some kinds of apples and pears, and then plums. But it's too late for cherries and strawberries.
Uncle Eugen, you forgot to mention the melons and the watermelons.
No, I didn't. They were to be the big surprise. If you can get up very early tomorrow, I'll take you to the melon garden. Early in the morning, the fruit is as cold as ice. Our melons are far better than bananas and oranges.
You have a lot of work in July and August, haven't you?
Yes, a good deal of work. Now the members of the cooperative farm are divided into brigades and teams. Some are working in the orchards, but most are harvesting in the fields. They are working with tractors, combines, and all sorts of agricultural machines. The harvest must be brought in a very short time.
Is most of the work mechanized on your cooperative farm?
Yes, most of it. Plowing, sowing, harvest gathering, milking and feeding the animals is mechanized. Ours is a big and rich cooperative farm. But it was not so when we started organizing the farm. Those were hard times. We barely made both ends meet. We were very poor. No machines, poor land, practically no cattle, men running away from the village to Plovdiv and the big towns. But we worked hard, and it was worth the trouble. The land has rewarded us for all our hard work, and we are getting richer every year.
I like your enthusiasm, Lubin. It explains your success. You wanted the cooperative system, you believed in it, you worked for it, and you worked hard. And now you can reap the fruits of your hard labor. Well, after breakfast, we can go to the orchard and begin work.
You keep speaking of going to work, but you keep on eating pancakes instead.
Well, we'll be off in a minute. Boris, do you know why we ask apricot pickers to whistle while they are working?
Why?
Because if they don't, they'll eat more fruit than they'll gather. You're pulling my leg.
Mummy, do you know I don't want to go to the orchard? Why, dear? It'll be great fun to see who will gather most. But, Mummy, didn't you hear what Auntie Lena's brother said? I can't whistle, Mummy. Uncle Eugen was only joking, dearie. We can eat as many apricots as we please. But be careful not to eat too many or you'll get a stomachache.
Come on, everybody. Follow me to the orchard.